Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So, it's Svelte's question time. You have any questions, I have answers for you. And the question for today is... How do you call a function from a parent component? How do you call a function from a parent component? A lot of times I hear this question and was like, can't you just pass a function in? But some people will say, hey, you should use component events because that is more decoupled and it's better. Or there's a lot of suggestions, right? So how do you do that? And I have prepared a comprehensive answer for this. So again, the question for today is, how do you call a function from your parent component? Okay, so how do you call a function from your parent component? Here I prepare a slide, which is only 3 slides. Hope you... So how do you call a function from a parent component? The first thing is... The key question of this question is... So a lot of times I will ask this, right? Question, what is the relationship between your component and its parent component? A lot of times... This is the key because like your parent component has one function and you want to call the function of your parent, right? So how do you actually call it? How do you call that function? The key is what is the relationship between your component and your parent component? Because there's three different scenarios and there's three different kind of solutions for this. So the first one is that your component itself is very tightly coupled with your parent's component. Your parents can't live without the component and component cannot live without your parent. So imagine you have a dialog component and inside a dialog component you have dialog header, dialog body, dialog actions, dialog footer and things like that. And they should always use it together and they can't, if you can't have a dialog without a dialog header, they have to live together, then you fall in the group number one. Right, which is you would have to pass a function directly to our children. Right, that is the best way and that's the way that I would recommend. However, sometimes your components may not care. Scenario 2 is your component may not care whether the parent exists at all. Right, so in this case would be you have a dialogue and you may have a dialogue header, but your dialogue header can be used elsewhere. It can be used as within a button or something like that, right? Okay, this is not a good idea. Okay, how about you have a button that acts that you can use it as your dialog actions, right? Your close buttons, your input buttons, your action buttons, secondary, primary buttons, all those buttons can be used in dialog, right? But actually, it does not have to be live within a dialog. It can be outside. It can be within a use standalone. It can be used in a menu bar and things like that. So the component does not have to care whether the parents exist or not. It does not even know whether it's being used inside a certain parent or not. Right? Then your parents, usually when you use a button, you have like an on-click function, right? You have functions that handle whenever your child component is being clicked. Right? So your child does not actually call that function directly, but the child component should actually dispatch a component event. And you allow the parents to pass that function into the component events listener and to be called that way. Right, so lastly is that your parents can have many components in however levels deep. What does that mean? So if you have a say like a menu bar, and the menu itself can be a lot of levels deep. So each of the menu item when you click, actually it may live inside a sub-menu list or main menu list or anything like that. And each of the button click on each of the menu item actually wants to call function from a parent, but not like the immediate parent. It can be calling a function that is like your ancestor, like in the main menu component, right? The main menu component has this function called on any menu item click, And each of the menu item will have to call that function to notify that, hey, I'm being clicked. But that menu item can be in however levels deep within a component's hierarchy. It can be within a means menu list and within a submenu list and then like a menu item, right? So that way, when you want to call this function, you want to call the main menu callback function of an on menu item click, you should be using context, right? You should be using context in that way. I feel that I would recommend you to use context to pass this function to all its children, and so that any animal components that is being lived within this menu will know that which parent component, which parent components are to be called. So let's take a look at some example that I've prepared over here. So remember, we have three different scenarios. I have three different examples to show that. Right, the first example is I have a dialog header. Right over here, my dialog component. Inside the dialog component, you have a dialog header, which allows you to kind of close, have a button and close this dialog together. Right. So the best way of doing this, I find that if your dialog header can't live without dialog, and dialog can't live without dialog header, then the easiest way is just pass this function directly as a props to your dialog header. Right. This way around, your dialog header, when you click on the close button, will just call this function directly. And that's all, right? You don't really need like decoupling, things like that. I mean, you can have that, but it doesn't matter, because there inherently in your code, there's already a very strong coupling happening. Your dialog can't live without dialog header. Dialog header cannot live without dialog. They have to be work together, right? And you try to forcefully decouple them in terms of code, but you always use them together. Then what's the point of doing that? So I find that this is the most efficient way of doing things, right? Okay, so let's move on to the next example, example 2. So example 2, remember the case where I say that component does not care whether the parent exists or not. And this happens in this case where I have a switcher component. Right, in this switcher component, actually I don't really care who I'm being used at. I don't even care whether the parent provides me have a callback function for being turned on or being turned off, right? I just take care of myself, right? I can just take care of on and off, things like that. Wait, it does not. Ah, okay. That's code issue, right? You just turn on and off. You don't really care about whether the parent has this function or the parent. Yeah, it has no requirements for the parents at all. So for the parents to kind of like want to know about this switcher component, wants to let switcher component call some of my function, right? This is more of a case where I want the switcher to call my function, right? The switcher can just don't care about whether the function or not. It's not its call function, right? In the dialog case where dialog header, when you close it, click this button, actually wants to close the dialog, right? There's a strong need over here, but for this switcher, it doesn't really care whether I need to do something on the parent side, right? I just like, okay, if you have function, well, I will just call you. If you don't have, it's up to me. It's fine for me as well. So in this case, I would recommend you to use component events, right? So here I would say I will come over here and have component events. So how you use component events is that you import a create event dispatcher from Svelte, and then you with that you create a dispatch function and a dispatch event. So dispatch the name of the event and the event detail, right? I have made a video that elaborate this more, so if you want to watch that, click on the link somewhere on top and on the description. Okay, so here to use it, I will have to listen to this event on turn on, and I pass in my function over here. So now my child, when I click on true, it will call this turn on function, right? It will call this function. But if I don't pass it, nothing will break. And I don't even know, I don't even care whether the function is being passed in. I just dispatch an event. So unlike the case of a dialog header, I would call this function directly, and this has to be defined, Right? If you don't define this function, then something wrong may happen, right? So if we talk about component events as a second example, let's take a look at the third example, third scenario. So the third scenario is, as I said, it's about parent can have as many components in however levels deep. Meaning, in this case, I want the example that I prepared is that the parent is called a counter component. Itself has two functions, the increment and decrement, right? So every time I increment, decrement, I will update this number over here, right? For some reason. Okay, so this could be like maybe like your shopping cart and things like that, where you have a lot of components inside, and each of them, when you try to add stuff, remove stuff, increase the quantity, change the voucher or whatever, you will update its parent to know that, oh hey, here is your updated price, right? So you have a function to calculate everything on the parent, and all the child needs to do is to notify your parents that, hey, something has changed, hey, do this, hey, do that. And you have a lot of this component, this children component in any levels deep, then I would suggest that you will use a context to pass a function to all your children, and it's up to them whether to call it or not, right? So here I set a context, I import context, and I need to provide a name for the context and provide something for the context. It could be a function directly, or in this case, I'm going to provide two functions. So instead of having a two different context name, I just pass it with the same name, but use an object to group two functions together. Right, so all the way to my children, I have my parent component or child components, all of them can actually get this context and get this function and call this function, right? So in my child two, I get decrement and call decrement, right? I may not even need to care about increments, I just need to call one function. In child, I call increments. In parents, I call increments with 10, right, times 10, right? So over here, you see that all its children needs to, the way for all your children to call this function from the parent, all of them will call the increment and decrement function from this parent, and the way of this parent passing them down to all these children is using a context. Right, so hopefully you see all these three different ways of passing a function to your child or even your grandchildren and let them to call you. Hopefully with this, you see that there's a lot of different ways to do it, and it really depends case by case. You don't have a one-size-fits-all solution. It does not always that decoupling is better or using context is better and things like that, right? It really depends on your use cases, and my suggestion to you is that always be flexible and open to try out different ideas and just use the simplest idea that fits you the best, right? Sometimes you see when you want to create a context, you need to set context and you want to get context. There's a lot of boilerplates to get things started and to achieve what, right? If you just want to pass a function and call that function, just pass it directly as a props and call it directly, right? That is the easiest way of all, right? So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions you'd like to ask, just like this question, because this is a short question time, I like to collect questions and try to answer all of them in my videos. So if you have any questions about this calling parent functions or any questions you have, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.